Good morning. Let's stand to call a worship in our bulletin on the screen shortly. In your Bible, Psalm 104. Normally we read it, I'll read the first line and you do the dark print and then we'll do the last line together. Praise the Lord, my soul, Lord, my God. You are clothed with splendor and majesty. The Lord wraps himself in light as with a garment. He stretches out the heavens like a tent and lay the beams of the upper chamber on their waters. He makes the clouds his chariot and rides on the wings of the wind. He makes winds his messengers, flames of fire his servants. He sets the earth on a foundation. It can never be removed. You set a boundary they cannot cross. Never again will they cover the earth. He makes springs pour water into the ravines. It flows between the mountains. They give water to all the beasts of the field. The wild donkeys quench their thirst. The birds of the sky nest by the waters. He waters the mountains from his upper chambers together. The land is satisfied by the fruit of his works. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Lord is good. The Lord is good.
Time.
And all the time.
God is good.
And all the time.
God is good.
God is good. We are happy to be in the presence of the Lord again this morning. And I'm sure you are also happy as I'm happy. Now it's summer. It's getting hotter, hotter each day. And we are praying to God to keep us safe from a lot of sicknesses that will be coming through this weather. So this morning we want to open our mouth and our heart to praise the name of the Lord who has kept us alive to see today. It is not by our power, it's not by our might, but by his grace. So I want us to appreciate him for all he has done in our lives, in our families, in our businesses, in our working places, and in this country, and in the world as a whole, for what he's doing. So we're going to sing the song, Give Thanks, with a grateful heart. Amen. Give thanks. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Give thanks. Give thanks to the Holy Heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. To the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. And now, and now. Let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us. And now. Because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks.
Give thanks.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord Most High. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved. Can we sing this song together? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes.
Oh, oh yeah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Most High. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Most High.
The name of the Lord.
The name of the Lord is a strong tower. Righteous run into it, and they are saved. The name of the Lord, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and they are saved.
Glory to the name,
glory to the name of the Lord. Oh, glory to the name of the Lord. The Lord Most High. Glory to the name, glory to the name of the Lord. Oh, glory to the name of the Lord. Glory to the name of the Lord Most High.
The name of the Lord.
The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous running to they are saved.
The name of the Lord
is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and they are saved.
Holy is the name of the Lord.
Holy, holy is the name of the Lord. Holy is the name of the Lord. Holy is the name of the Lord. Most High. Holy, holy is the name of the Lord. Holy is the name of the Lord. Holy is the name of the Lord. Most High.
The name of the Lord.
The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and they are saved. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it, and they are saved. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Most High. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Most High.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Most High. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Most High.
Hallelujah. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The love of the Lord supersede every other love. So we're praying this morning that God will draw us close to Himself. Lord, I come to you.
Lord, I come to you. Let my heart be changed, renewed, flowing from the grace that I found in you. Lord, I've come to know. Lord, I've come to know the weaknesses I find in me will be stripped away by the power of your love. Hold me close to you. Hold me close. Let your love surround me. Bring me near. To your side, and as I wait, I'll rise up like the eagle, and I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on in the power of your love. Lord, unveil my eyes. Lord, unveil my eyes. Let me see you face to face. The knowledge of your love as you live in me. Lord, renew my mind. Lord, renew my mind as your will unfold in my life, in living every day. By the power of your love, hold me close to you. Draw me to your side, and as I wait, I'll rise up like the eagle, and I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on, and the power of your love. Hold me close, hold me close, hold me close to you. Hold me close, let your love surround me. Oh, bring me in, draw me to your side, draw me to your side. And I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on in the power of your love. And I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on. And I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on in the power of your love. Thank you, Jesus. And before we were born, he knew us. He knows our names, and he knows what we are passing through. He knows what we are going through. Even what the world is going through right now, he knows. So we need to be rest assured that God is involved in whatever thing we are going through. I have a maker.
King, he was
Let the whole church sing, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I lift my voice. Joy, my King. Take joy, my King. In what you in. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your. For the last time, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. And I lift my voice. And I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul. Rejoice, take joy, take. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound. Let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. Amen.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, when God rotates, there is no shadow. God has all knowledge you know. For God, anything is possible. God is everywhere. God is control of life and death. Gives life and salvation. Praise God for giving us Jesus. Worship the name of the Lord. Gives us the grace we need. We want to live as a person who saves our neighbors with that grace. Bless the preacher. Let it be a time of grace. Have pity on the members who are suffering. Please join us in fellowship time. Also this week, in the name of Jesus, let us live in victory. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Open your Bible to Gospel of Luke, chapter 5, verse 12 to 16. Gospel of Luke, chapter 5, verse 12 through 16. Let's read them in one voice. While he was in one of the cities, there came a man full of leprosy. And when he saw Jesus, he fell on his face and begged him, Lord, if you will, you can make me clean. And Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him, saying, I will be clean. And immediately the leprosy left him. And he charged him to tell no one, but go and show yourself to the priest and make an offering for your cleansing, as Moses commanded, for proof to them. But now even more the report about him went abroad, and great crowds gathered to hear him and to be healed of their infirmities. But he would withdraw to desolate places and pray. Amen.
굿모닝. It's a nice day, I guess. it's a nice day today, and I am really happy to see everyone today coming to this church, and also to those who are joining us online. Before we start, can we greet each other by saying, I bless you. Welcome. Welcome, welcome. Yes, today I bless you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and we welcome you today in our heart of worship. Yes, it's okay. It's okay. Yes. Last week, we have learned together about Jesus calling his disciples, Peter, Andrew, James, and John. And after catching a lot of fish, his disciples left the fish full of boat, fish, and followed Jesus. And today, it is a story about a man full of leprosy. And today, Jesus cleansed this man. The word leprosy in the Bible only appears 4 times. Among 4, 2 appears in Luke, in our text today. The disease itself, leprosy, only appears 4 times. And we could see that there is a slight difference of the story in Matthew and Mark. In Matthew and Mark, they pictured the man, elaborate the man named leper, the leper. But here in our text today, in verse 12, we could see Luke describe the man, a man full of leprosy, a man full of leprosy. In our Bible, there's the word leprosy. Is not the leprosy the same as we know today. If you have your Bibles with you, please look at the footnote at the bottom, and you could see that leprosy was a term for several skin diseases, and it includes different kinds of skin disease. So it's not only the leprosy that we know today. Every kind of skin diseases were included as leprosy at that time. Unlike today, before the ancient time, there were no medicines, there were no cure for this disease. That is why in the Old Testament, God gave them a commandment about leprosy. If you look at Leviticus chapter 13 and 14, it contains about the law, about how to do about leprosy, if you have one, if someone have leprosy. If we read chapter 13, we can see different kinds of skin diseases, like white spots. It is called leprosy, or reddish spots, or white hair, or eruption of skin, itchiness, swelling. This was called leprosy at that time. We could see that only in the Old Testament, only one person was cured of leprosy. It was Naaman, who was cured by Prophet Elisha. So it was a very terrible skin disease or illness at that time. And in the law of the Old Testament, if someone have a leprosy, that man must be isolated. That man must show himself to the priest, and if the priest decided you have a leprosy, you are a leper, then that man needs to go out of the camp. It means going out to the outside of the city wall. And it's not only for a man, even the king or even a priest have a leprosy, they cannot do their jobs. King, like King Uzziah, was separated from the kingdom, another temple. A priest cannot serve in the tent of meeting. So this was a serious disease at that time. And we could see that Israelites have this kind of thinking. If you have leprosy, it is a curse given by God. Why? Because the word itself tells us, in Hebrew term of leprosy means heat, to heat, or to throw down is the word of leprosy in Hebrew terms. It means God throw them down. It is a curse thrown them by God. The Israelites thought about this. That's why people of Israel looked at them as unclean person. We could see in Leviticus chapter 13, verse 46, he is unclean. He shall live alone. His dwelling shall be outside the camp. So they looked at the leper as unclean person. That is why they were set out. They were isolated outside the camp. And the rules, the law about leper, if ones have a leprosy, it is said in Leviticus chapter 13, verse 45, the leprous person who has the disease shall wear torn clothes and let the hair of his head hang loose and shall cover his upper lip and cry out, unclean, unclean. But then today in our text, a man full of leprosy saw Jesus Christ and then went to him, bow down to him. We could see he didn't shout unclean, unclean to separate person from him. We could see that it somehow this man didn't follow the law. And this kind of law means that person is a dead person, because torn clothes, hair loose, it means that person is dead, or a relative or family is dead at the time. We could see that the society is divided of unclean and clean, those who have leprosy or not. the society is divided. And the Israelites look at the person who have leprosy. They first look at them as a leper, not as a man. But then today, Jesus Christ came to this man. He was one who was in of the city, but then we could see, as I said, leper was located outside of the camp. But Jesus was in the place where a leper can see. A leper can go near to Jesus Christ. It means Jesus was outside of the city walls, so that the leper was able to come near to Jesus. And what is more interesting about this text is about the conversation between the leper and Jesus Christ. Let us see. When the man first saw Jesus, he fell on his face and begged to Jesus Christ. He said, "Lord, if you will, you can make me clean. If you will, you can make me clean." And Jesus stretched out his arms, his hands, and touched the leper, and saying, "I will be clean." And immediately the leprosy left that man. As we know, a man cannot touch unclean things or unclean person. If a man touches unclean things, that man would be unclean. So he needs to show, give offerings to God for the cleanliness, must be isolated because he is unclean or she is unclean. But then Jesus Christ stretched out his arms and hands and touched this man and healed this person. So in this conversation, I would like to let us focus on the first sentence about the words from the leper. It is said, "If you will, you can make me clean." In other words, I could better say it like this. If you ever want, you are able to make me clean. If you ever want. Lord, if you ever want, you are able to make me clean. I think this man full of leprosy may have the desires in his heart. Yes, I want to be clean. I want to ask Jesus Christ to make me clean and heal from this leprosy. Full of leprosy from head to toe, I want to ask him to heal me. But then we could see in his request, he didn't say, "Lord, heal me." But he said, "If you want, Lord, if you want, you are able to heal me." In this context, in this text, we cannot see any desires of him to be healed. But instead, we could see that he acknowledged the power of Jesus Christ. He acknowledged the power of Jesus Christ. He knew that Jesus is able to clean him, to cleanse him and heal him. And we could see Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ said, "I do want to be clean. Jesus answered, I want to, and you be clean. Actually, Jesus has the power to clean and heal the sick with his words. Just saying one word, be healed, the sickness, the illness, all the leprosy can be healed. But then we would like to focus on his actions first. What did Jesus do? Jesus stretched his arms and touched the leper. I think this is one of the important things we can find in this text. As I said, leper was isolated outside the camp. No one can touch him. No one can go near to him. So maybe this is the first time of someone other than him touching his flesh. I don't know that he may have felt the touch of Jesus Christ because of the skin disease that he had, but then this is the first touch of other person aside from him, aside from the leper. From this, we could see that Jesus knew about the law. He cannot touch the unclean. But then we couldn't see any hesitation. We couldn't see any hesitation about touching the leper. And he said, I do want to be clean. This amazing thing didn't just stop by cleansing and healing of the leper. We could see in the next verses that Jesus commanded the leper to be silent about this miracle happened to him. But instead, go to the priest and show his body that he is clean and give offering to God for the cleansing as Moses commanded, and then be clean. And that is what Jesus commanded. Why did Jesus command this kind of things? Because it is written in the law. It is the culture. It is about the law that they obey. Jesus didn't disregard the law of the Israel, but he was in the law of Israel. That is why he commanded the man to show himself to the priest that he was cleansed. He was clean. His leprosy is gone. Why do the man need to do this kind of things? It is because only by the priest, officially, only by the priest can announce that he is clean. So even though he was clean, but he didn't go and show to the priest, then he is not clean. He's unclean, officially. To be officially clean, the man must go to the priest and show himself that he is clean. Then why did Jesus ask this thing to the leper? It is because Jesus wanted this leper to be inside of the community, inside of the society. He wanted to send this leper back to his family again. Why? Because this man was so lonely and alone and used to be alone. But then Jesus command this man to force him go back to the community, go back to the society. And this news spread all the way to other countries. Everyone knew about this one. So everyone came to hear the word of God, hear the word of Jesus, and to be healed. But then we could see Jesus withdrawing from this, from fame, and to about people want to be with Jesus Christ. We could see here that Jesus wants to be connected to God. Jesus wants to be connected to God. It is said in verse 16, he would withdraw to desolate place and pray. We could see it is a normal thing to Jesus to go to desolate place and to have his own time to be connected to God. So if we summarize, this story, we could have two things to remember. First, we need to ask the question, how do we see yourself? How do you see yourself? How do we see ourselves? And how do we see others? Do we see ourselves or others? Firstly, as a man, not by the appearances, not by characteristics. Do we see them as themselves? Unlike Israel, they have all the categories fitted to men, and they divide people by sickness, clean and unclean. How about us? Do we do the same thing? Are we just seeing people as themselves? We need to have these questions. Second one is, are we trying to be connected in two ways, connected to God and connected to the people who were isolated or who were separated from the society or to other people in the family or in other circumstances? Are we connecting? Are we connecting to God and to those who were separated or who were isolated? This is the two questions to remember for today. I would like to ask you to imagine if you were that leper, you were outside of the house. You cannot come into the house with your family. You cannot touch them. You cannot go near to your family or friends or to this church. How would you feel? It is said, in according to studies, that people who have leprosy to this day, they feel sad, not only because of their bodies, but they have guilt that even though they don't have sin, they ask and question themselves, did I have something wrong? They have this guilt in their heart. And they are burdened in their bodies and as well as in psychologically. They have this kind of burdens. And if we continue to be alone, separated by means of our circumstances or because of you choose to be alone, it will continue, it may result in loneliness, also self-hatred because of your sickness or your weaknesses. But then we must think about Jesus Christ. Jesus destroyed this kind of boundaries. He touched, he stretched his arms and touched the people who were isolated at that time. Let us remember that Jesus came to this world to stretch his arm to those who were isolated, separated from the society. And today of our text, God is also inviting us. God is also inviting us to be like Jesus, to be the little hands and feet of Jesus that stretches arms and touching the people who were isolated from the society. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you today that we have learned together about Jesus who destroyed the boundaries and stretched his arms and touched the people who were isolated or separated from the society. We ask to give us a strength and power and wisdom and knowledge to do as Jesus did, to be the little hands and feet of Jesus, to go and touch and stretch our arms and hands to those people who are separated to God, isolated by society, so that we may bring them and connect them to you and to the church community as well. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for coming to Heart of Worship. Actually, do we have newcomers here? Anyone? Let's stand up for a sec. Yeah, thanks. Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you. And we are celebrating birthdays in June. Please, do we have anyone who has birthday in June? Please come forward. Anyone?
Yes, we have a lot of birthday celebrants today. Okay. Anyone else? Birthday is on June. No one? Okay. Before we blow this candle, let us sing Happy Birthday. 1, 2, 3, go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Okay. 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 Before I pray for our members, for the birthday celebrants of this month, let us ask, when is your birthday? 5월 18일. Ah, okay. 6월 16일. June 16. Oh, June 1st. Oh, just past birthday.
June 27.
7th. Oh, almost near?
10.
Oh, three days separate. So let us remember this these birthdays, and let us maybe celebrate them on the chat group, so we may encourage and make their day happy on Kakao. Okay, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving and sending our precious members who are the birthday celebrants for this month. Father, we ask for your mercy and grace and love, kindness, and all the good things that you may give us. We want to ask you to give everything that you may give to their lives. And we want to bless these members that they may be the little hands and feet of Jesus to go and stretch the arms, their hands, and touch the people who were separated or isolated from the society, to family, or to you. Father, we want to ask you all the good things in their lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let us once more give a round of applause to them.
Today we decided to go out for outing, but the weather is not clear enough, and it will rain soon, sooner or later. So we decide to be here in same room because of the reason that we cannot go out. So please remain seated after worship, and we will have some activities. After that, we will provide you some food, but the church regulations, we cannot eat food or things in here. So please remember it. And 12th of June, Mission Connect Worship is held in first floor, Kunsepore, and it's called Mission Connecting Worship. It will start at 7:30 p.m. on first floor, and the service will be there, and the preacher will be Pastor Nick. So it's not mandatory, but please come and have worship together. And 25th of June to 16th of July, every Sunday at Eden Hall on third floor, there will be a prayer meeting for preparation of sending missionaries. So please remember that and come and have prayer meeting together. And July 30th and 31st, Mission Department, they decided to have Sunday camp. There will be some activities from 6 p.m. 4 p.m. to 10 p.m. And after that, 31st, we will have service at 7:30, and we'll go rafting after that. So there's a regulation fee. It is small, but probably some people it is big. The regulation fee is adult. For adults, it is 1 1만 원, 10 10,000 won, and child for child 5,000 won. So please, if you are interested, then tell your cell leaders. Yeah. We'll collect the how many going to participate in. So please tell them. And that's about it, I think. Yeah.
Okay. Let us pray for our offering and finish our worship with the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you once again to gather us today in this worship place. Father, we give you our offering and tithes to you. Please bless this offering and tithes that it may be used to your ministry to expand your kingdom in this world. Especially, we want to ask you that this offering and tithes may be used to the ministry that could stretch the arms and hands to the people who are isolated or separated to you. Let us finish our worship with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we have forgiven our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.